Nick Kyrgios. The name alone brings a reaction, an opinion, a freakish talent. And a polarising figure.
And I just ignored Fergus Murphy. Yeah. I mean, it's hard not to laugh, it really is.
Nick Kyrgios is an entertainer, an enigma, rarely seen in the sometimes robotic nature of tennis. We're currently witnessing Nick's deepest Grand Slam run of his career, so I thought we would take a look back at the rollercoaster ride which is the career of Nick Kyrgios. A Canberra native born to a Greek father and a Malay mother, he was one of three siblings growing up, and Kyrgios would pick up his first racket at the age of six. He was described as chubby and immobile, which meant early on he would have to develop an original game. Kyrgios often found training boring as a kid. He hated practice and often only liked drills that included scoring, as it engaged his competitiveness. Being an asthmatic, he could not run with fluidity, and often relied off winners off his heels and immense touch to win points. By the time Nick was 10, he was playing in Australia's 12 and under national championships. By his early teens, he would be travelling the world on the junior tour. Kyrgios' young tennis career was causing financial strain on his parents, with his father a house painter and his mother a computer engineer. They would often work overtime to support Nick's tennis. Both his parents, George and Norlayla, would decide to put all their money into Nick's career in hopes that it would go somewhere. Nick would make the decision to give up basketball, his first sporting love, a sport that he would excel in as a kid, making local representative sides, with it arguably his desired career option. He knew though how talented he was at playing tennis and decided to completely give up on his basketball dreams. At 15, Kyrgios would be offered funding by moving to the Australian Institute of Sport of Tennis, which he did accept and saw drastic improvements in his game. He would say the period at the AIS improved his physique and diet, but he desperately missed the game of basketball and still disliked the repetition of training. By 16, he had two junior Grand Slam doubles titles and had rose to number 3 on the singles junior tour. His crowning moment would come in the following year in 2013 at the Australian Boys Open Final, as he defeated fellow Australian and good mate Thanasi Kokkinakis in straight sets. Only 6 months later, both Kyrgios and Kokkinakis would team up at Wimbledon to participate in the junior doubles tournament. Here the doubles partnership named Special K was formed, as they stormed through their opponents, winning the Wimbledon Junior Grand Slam title, Kyrgios' third of his career. Kyrgios, even through the junior years, was impatient at times and was also very expressive on the court. He would peak at number 1 in the world on the Junior World Tour, marking a dominant junior career. Kyrgios had in fact already started participating in pro events in 2012, competing on the ITF men's circuit, finishing his first year at 838th in the rankings. 2013 would give us a glimpse of the immense talent Nick possessed as he set his goal to enter the top 300 by year's end. Kyrgios would smash even his own expectations with a couple highlights throughout the year. A massive underdog win against former world number 8 Radek Stefanik in his Grand Slam debut at the French Open, and his first Challenger Tour title win at the Sydney International, which he won at just 17. This meant by year's end, Kyrgios' rank had rose to 182. 2014 would be the year that Kyrgios would start to become a household name in the world of tennis. His breakout game would be his round of 16 match against world number 1 Rafael Nadal at Wimbledon in 2014. In his debut at Wimbledon, at just 19 years of age, he would have the performance of a lifetime. His play the weeks prior had given him the momentum with a Challenger tournament win over fellow Aussie Sam Groth, his fourth of his career, and a title that would grant him a wildcard spot into Wimbledon. His second round performance against former world number 13 Richard Gasquet at Wimbledon was insanely clutch, with Kyrgios showing immense resolve. Down 2-0, he would come back and level the match, saving 3 match points, almost throwing it away, double faulting on Gasquet's match point, which he would challenge and win the challenge. He would then save a total of 9 match points, break Gasquet's serve, and would serve out the match. Kyrgios set the tone early against Nadal, hitting an ace down the tee. He would ace one of the greatest returners a whopping 37 times and hit a total of 70 winners, absolutely dominating the match. Kyrgios showed desire and passion, but also his innate creativity with his tweener at 3-3 in the second set. Truly brilliant, almost freakish. Moments like this made the tennis world enamoured by Nick's game, and to this point, he was well liked by the general public, considered to be the next star of the sport. Kyrgios would take the match in four sets, but would bow out in the quarterfinals against Milos Raonic. Become the first debutant to reach the quarterfinals since 2004, and the first teenager to defeat a world number one in a Grand Slam event since 2005, and the first man to do this outside the top 100 since 1992. His ranking went from 144 to 66 in the world, entering the top 100 for the first time in his career. Kyrgios would finish off the season solidly, making it to the third round of the US Open before absolutely obliterating two rackets, his first show of anger at a Grand Slam, something fans would become accustomed to over his career. 2014 would end with Kyrgios ranked at 52nd, the second ranked Australian at the time after Leighton Hewitt. Murray in the quarterfinals, but would see his rank move to a career-high 35th in the world. The wheels were starting to turn for Kyrgios' career at this point. We would see another example of Kyrgios' bad temper though, as he was fined $5,000 for swearing and racket smashing for his second consecutive Grand Slam. This streak of bad behaviour would continue throughout 2015, but he was still playing decent tennis, reaching his first ATP tournament final at the Estoril Open, losing to Richard Gasquet. A week later, he would face world number 2 Roger Federer. In another outstanding display, he would save two match points in the final set tiebreaker to win against yet another legend. When Kyrgios was on, he was on, and he was absolutely electrifying tennis audiences. Kyrgios yet again turned up on the big stage with Federer being his biggest scalp of the 2015 season. Third and fourth round exits in this year's Grand Slams meant it was a decent year, but there were questions about Nick's drive. With 10 Grand Slam wins and only 2 ATP wins prior to his finalist appearance at Estoril and the round of 16 finish in Madrid, it seemed Kyrgios was only choosing to show up in the big events. His character had definitely become a serious issue. Smashing his racket, which bounced into the stands in a loss against Milos Raonic, and allegedly tanking at Wimbledon in 2015, he would follow it up by generating serious controversy at the 2015 Rogers Cup with Stan Wawrinka, making a claim that involved Thanasi Kokkinakis, Kyrgios' mate, and Stan Wawrinka's girlfriend. Fined $13,000 for his comments and suspended for 28 days, with Kyrgios falling out of the top 40 to conclude the 2015 year. He'd become enemy number one in the public domain in Australia, with his Sydney Morning Herald article labelling him as a national embarrassment. This sentiment wasn't held by everyone, as he still had a cult following from some who believed that he made tennis entertaining either way. At just 22 years of age, he had already become the most polarising name in the sport. A Hopman Cup win in 2016 was a great bounce back, his first title on the professional world tour. He would bow out early at the Aussie Open, but would win the title in Marseille, beating world number 10 Gasquet in the quarterfinal, world number 8 Berdych in the semi-final, and world number 12 Cilic in the grand final, all in straight sets. Kyrgios finished the tournament without having his serve broken. He then at the Miami Open reached his first ATP World Tour Masters 1000 semi-final, which moved him into the top 20 in the world, the youngest player to reach that echelon since Marin Cilic 7 years earlier. Kyrgios was still being an absolute menace, collecting fines for fun, banned for 8 weeks for his lack of effort at the Shanghai Masters, saying at one point, "Can you call time so I can finish this match and go home?" But as a whole, he was performing well, winning his first ATP 250 title in Atlanta, and his first ATP 500 title at the Japan Open, his most prestigious final win to date. He followed this up by defeating Novak Djokovic not once, but twice in 2017, at both the Mexican Open and the Indian Wells tournament. He became one of two players ever, along with Leighton Hewitt, to win his first career meeting with Nadal, Federer, and Djokovic. A finals appearance at the Cincinnati Masters 1000 may have been his biggest achievement to date, plus a loss against Nadal in the China Open was another good showing, but Kyrgios was yet to reach those immense heights once set upon him. Inconsistency and anger still hampered his game, and he was open about why, quoted saying, "It's just a game, it's just a sport, it's such a small part of my life. But I'd rather be doing tennis than working at Chipotle or something." He said, "For me, it's an easy way to make money, I'm just hitting a ball over the net." The death of his grandfather and grandmother and the constant touring had affected his mental health significantly. He desired a life of normality, saying, "I can honestly say winning a Grand Slam would not make me the happiest man on earth. As I wrote previously, I just love being a normal guy and having enough money to live a normal life. I don't need the excess money at all. We're all a lot different." Nick Kyrgios was clearly conflicted, and it was becoming more apparent that the outbursts on the court may be stemming from something a lot deeper than just frustration over a game of tennis. Nick had gone through five coaches as a pro, but would decide to go without a coach for the foreseeable future, Kyrgios, outside of his Brisbane International win, his first ATP title since 2016, struggled tremendously in 2018 for the most part because of injury, missing the entirety of the clay season because of his elbow. He would not reach past the fourth round of any of the major tournaments, withdrawing from the 2018 tour early, citing reoccurring issues with his elbow and seeing a psychologist to improve his mental health. Questions were being asked. Was Nick cut out for professional tennis? In this yo-yo of a career, 2019 may have brought him the biggest highs and lows. After a poor display in Australia to start the year, he would possibly have his most dominant run of his entire career, playing scintillating tennis in Acapulco, defeating three top opponents in Rafael Nadal, John Isner, Alexander Zverev, and three-time Grand Slam champion Stan Wawrinka, winning his fifth career title. He followed this up with an absolutely opposite display in Miami, where he had multiple altercations with spectators and the smashing of rackets across the tournament, acknowledging his opponent being more disciplined and questioned his own motivation for the sport again. He then possibly had his biggest meltdown yet in Rome, in a match against Casper Ruud, where he threw a chair on the court and proceeded to swear at a linesman. In true Kyrgios fashion, he followed that outburst with a masterclass in Washington, defeating two top 10 opponents, beating both Stefanos Tsitsipas and Daniil Medvedev, en route to his sixth title of his career. To end his 2019 season, he would conduct his biggest outburst yet, resulting in a $113,000 fine, a 16-week suspended ban, and a further $25,000 fine because of his behaviour at the Cincinnati Masters. His misbehaviour included smashing rackets in the corridor,
just ignored Fergus Murphy, yeah,
berating the chair umpire, and spitting at the umpire.
We're likely to see
it's all right.
This fine was the largest in ATP history. Due to the pandemic, the 2020 season was heavily restricted as Kyrgios would only take part at the Aussie Open, which he bowed out in the fourth round to Rafael Nadal, his best Grand Slam performance in 2 years. He would use this tournament to help respond to the 2020 bushfires in Australia, significantly donating to bushfire relief. His other off-court endeavours are his NK Foundation, a foundation that plans to build a facility for disadvantaged and underprivileged kids through sport. By the end of 2020, he ranked 45th in the world, withdrawing from the back end of the year due to the pandemic. 2021 was much of the same, with a stop-start tour because of the pandemic and travel issues. Kyrgios would end that year with a knee injury, finishing 93rd in the ATP rankings. Starting the year with issues with COVID and asthma, he'd miss both the Melbourne and Sydney tournaments prior to the Australian Open, falling out of the top 100 for the first time in 8 years. A second round exit at the 2022 Aussie Open would end his single campaign, but he still remained active in the doubles as he's teamed up with Thanasi Kokkinakis. A major throwback to the days as the Special K duo, from their time winning the Oz Open together on the junior scene, they accomplished something truly special in 2022. The unseeded duo would defeat the world number 1, number 3, and number 6 doubles teams en route to the Grand Slam final. Kyrgios, who sometimes looks lonely out there on the court in singles matches, thrived off Kokkinakis' energy as they would win an All-Australian Grand Final over Matthew Ebden and Max Purcell. Kyrgios and Kokkinakis became the first wildcard pairing in the Open era to win the Australian Open's men's doubles title, an insane achievement. Kyrgios would build off this, with deep runs in Miami, Stuttgart and Halle, beating multiple top 10 talents along the way. The verbal tirades were still on show, with them present in both Miami and Houston, but that honestly was to be expected at this point. He would skip Roland Garros for the fifth consecutive year, with Kyrgios priming himself for Wimbledon on grass, historically his best surface. Not much was expected from Nick coming into Wimbledon unseeded. A five-set win over wildcard Paul Judd that involved abusing a judge and spitting in the direction of a spectator didn't really change anything for the critics. He would defeat 26-seed Filip Krajinovic in 3 sets, and then the 4-seed Tsitsipas in 4 sets, in which was a fiery battle. Nick got under the skin of Tsitsipas with his famous underarm serves and his overall power. It resulted in Tsitsipas absolutely hammering balls at Nick and hammering 2 balls into the direction of the crowd as well, in a match where Tsitsipas made Nick look like the good guy, a pretty hard thing to do. Kyrgios would fight back in the round of 16 against a brave Brandon Nakashima in a 5-set victory to reach his first major quarterfinal since the 2015 Australian Open. A straight sets win against Christian Garin in the quarterfinal meant Nick was through to the semis against legend Rafael Nadal. Nick had been incredibly composed during the tournament from round 2 onwards. You could see that the quarterfinal victory meant so much to him. Nadal would announce after his 5-set marathon against Taylor Fritz, he had a serious abdomen injury, and he was unsure whether he could compete in the semi-finals. A day later, he would announce that he was unable to compete, granting Nick Kyrgios a spot in the Wimbledon Grand Final, an amazing achievement. Through the many trials and tribulations, few expected the flawed Kyrgios to reach a Grand Slam final, but there he was. Even Nick himself admitted that he didn't think that this was always possible, saying, "I honestly thought my ship had sailed. I didn't go about things great earlier on in my career, and I thought I may have wasted that little window." No matter what side of the fence you sit on in terms of Nick Kyrgios, his resolve to get to the top of tennis must be appreciated. From a chubby asthmatic kid from Canberra to now a Wimbledon Grand Finalist, let's all get behind our Aussie in his quest for Grand Slam gold. Hey everyone, I hope you enjoyed this long piece on the enigma that is Nick Kyrgios. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe for more sports documentary content. Go Nick!